as we marvel at the beautiful countryside, cities and cathedrals of Russia. The great romantic composers struggled to express their artistry within an oppressive political climate. Their music often reflected their personal and political defiance for the Communist Party. The music we are hearing is from pictures at an exhibition by Modest Mussorgsky. His promenade served to connect the pictures, lives and music of Russia's finest composers. Most of these masters studied and later taught at three Russian conservatories in Kiev, Moscow and St. Petersburg. We will visit the homes, lives, passions and music of these great masters, including Rimsky-Korsakov, Shostakovich, Glieri, Tchaikovsky, Rachmaninov, Borodin, Kusevitsky, Mussorgsky. Modest Mussorgsky was an innovator of Russian music in deliberate defiance of the traditional styles of Western music. While Mussorgsky suffered personally from alcoholism, it was also a behavior pattern considered typical for those of Mussorgsky's generation who wanted to oppose the Russian political establishment. Mussorgsky spent day and night in St. Petersburg's tavern of low repute. The distinguished English composer William Walton described Shostakovich as the greatest composer of the 20th century. Some modern composers characterized Shostakovich as a hack, vulgar, strident and brutally monotonous. Shostakovich was obsessed with clean lines. He synchronized the clocks in his home and regularly sent himself cards to test how well the postal service was working. He loved sports and was a qualified football referee and part owner of his favorite hometown team.
In 1948, Shostakovich composed the song cycle from Jewish folk poetry. This cycle could not be performed until after Stalin's death, in March 1953. My son is the most beautiful in the world. Spark in the darkness. Your father, in chains in Siberia, the king keeps him in prison. Sleep.
Tchaikovsky was the first Russian composer whose music made a lasting impression internationally. The Nutcracker composed in 1892, and you are hearing the Waltz of the Flowers. This melody is followed by the Russian folk dance Trepak.
Reingold Glier. He was educated at the Moscow Conservatory. His style combined broad lyricism, rich, colorful harmony. Glier's four pieces, of which Barry is playing two movements, are considered the greatest pieces of romantic bass music ever written by world-renowned composers. This intermezzo showcases the beautiful melodic sound of the bass. This beautiful intermezzo is followed by Glier's brilliant tarantella. The tarantella is a fast and furious ritual folk dance that is supposed to release the toxic poison from the bite of a tarantula. A Alexander Baradin was a Russian romantic composer, chemist, and physician. Baradin founded the School of Medicine for Women in St. Petersburg, where he taught until 1885. Music remained a secondary vocation for Dr. Baradin outside his main career as a physician. Baradin's music is full of romantic charm and enticing melodies. The evocative musical spirit of Baradin's music made possible the adaptation of his compositions from his string quartet number 2 and the musical Kismet.
Sergei Rachmaninoff was a composer, virtuoso pianist, and conductor of the late Romantic period. Rachmaninoff possessed an uncanny memory. He could hear a piece of music, even a symphony, then play it back the next day, the next year, or a decade after that. Along with his musical gifts, Rachmaninoff possessed physical gifts that included exceptional height, 6'3", and extremely large hands with a gigantic finger stretch. Rachmaninoff left Russia in 1918 and settled in the United States as a successful conductor, composer, and concert pianist, where he wrote his famous works including Rhapsody on a Theme of Paganini, Symphony No. 3, and Symphonic Dances and his beautiful vocalise. Sergei Kusevitsky was a Russian-born conductor, composer, and double bassist, known for his long tenure as music director of the Boston Symphony Orchestra from 1924 to 1949.
These images come from Tanglewood, the summer home of the Boston Symphony, where Kusevitsky also mentored his famous student, Leonard Bernstein. In 1906, Kusevitsky wrote two short pieces for solo bass, entitled Vals Miniature and Chanson Triste. You are actually hearing Kusevitsky playing his vals in this 1930 recording.
Nikolai Rimsky-Korsakov was a Russian composer and a master of orchestration. Flight of the Bumblebee is an orchestral interlude from his opera The Tale of Tsar Saltan. This piece is intended to musically evoke the seemingly chaotic and rapidly changing flying pattern of a bumblebee. In this final segment of From Russia with Love, the sound of the nimble bumblebee will be played on the big double bass. Barry prefers to change the title to a more appropriate Flight of the Rumblebee.